What are the factors making up the skyrocketing price of gasoline? Crude oil has surged from $45 per barrel in 2004 to more than $135 a barrel now. Investor speculation, uncertainty over supplies, and rising demand from other countries are certainly factors. There's a debate going on over whether or not we are experiencing an oil bubble and if these high prices at the pump will continue. Here to help us sort through all that is ASU economist Tracy Clark. Tracy, good to have you in the program again. Thanks for joining us. How much is speculation pushing this, well, let's call it a bubble for now?
Well, I think that if you were just looking at demand factors, we might have $80-$85 a barrel oil. So the rest of it is some combination of fears over supply and speculative activity by investors.
So speculation is a factor. I kind of jumped the gun a little bit, though. Is this a bubble?
Well, in the sense that some of the price is not related to supply and demand factors directly, yes, you could call it a bubble. It's not a very big one yet. And I don't know how much farther it's going to go, because typically in these kinds of situations, if you don't have these fears over supply, then there's nothing for the speculators to really work with. And right now, we haven't had any new disasters in the supply for oil. If that holds, if we don't have any new things to worry about, this price of oil may have stabilized for a while.
I was going to say, some folks consider a bubble happening when supply overwhelms demand, and that certainly isn't happening right now.
No, that's not what's happening right now. We're having a little bit the same kind of bubble that we had in the real estate market, where people were bidding up prices and it wasn't really connected to the number of people they thought were going to demand it, the actual demand, or in essence, really, the supply. It was totally disconnected between those two. And right now, there's some speculative activity that is just a result of people thinking that there's an opportunity here for them to move the prices, and they are indeed moving the prices some.
Begs the question, who's doing the speculating?
All the people that were doing the speculating, first in the stock market, then in the real estate. Now, since they can't do the real estate and the stock market still doesn't look that good, they've got to put the money somewhere. And really, literally, what they've done is put it into the commodity markets, and that's why we're seeing this speculative activity.
To that thought, should there be and will there be more regulation and more oversight in essential commodities?
I don't see the same push right now. Certainly, if we were to get a bubble the likes of that we saw in the real estate market, where almost all the increase in price activity for almost 2 years was investor-driven, then you would probably see some pretty heavy calls. Right now, we're only seeing a portion of the price volatility being speculative activity. The rest of it is plain old fear and changes in demand and supply.
There's some thought that whatever this is, bubble by any name, isn't going to burst until the recession hits and hits hard. You agree?
Well, certainly a recession would pull back on prices, would make the commodities a lot less attractive to investors, but you would have to have demand fall not only here, but in Europe and in places like China and India.
There's kind of another strand of thought here that the prices are high, yes, much higher than we're used to, yes. But these prices now are where they should have been all along.
There is some degree of truth to the idea that for a while, prices weren't where they should have been given the price of oil. And right now, with oil at 100 and, well, right now, the last number I saw was 128, but that was just a a little bit of a retreat, that the people that are doing the refining and the selling of the oil are absorbing some of this price into their losses, and that oil, you know, gasoline prices would be a little bit higher if that weren't the case. And so we're still not in a situation where there's a one-to-one correspondence between the price of gasoline and where the oil currently is. It's also true that if something happens to actually lower supply, or there's something that would make people fear that supply would be a lot lower, and if oil prices go up significantly, at $200 a barrel, you might be seeing $6 gasoline.
Well, you would not only be seeing $6 gasoline, but you'd be seeing folks in a lot of parts of this country come wintertime unable to pay for heating.
You would. Under those circumstances, it would be very difficult. We're already seeing people cut back on their energy consumption. Year to date, about 0.6%. And you may think, well, that's not very much. Well, people are going to cut back more, I think. But overall, it takes a lot to make people consume less energy. And that we've seen any drop at all says that we're getting to a price point where people are sensitive to the price of the energy and they are going to cut back.
Weaker dollar, how much is that playing into all this?
It has played a role to this point. The dollar's actually firmed up against, like, the euro, the primary currency that we've been dropping against, because there's weakness in the euro countries. If that persists, the dollar may in fact start strengthening against the euro, and that could take a little bit of pressure off us, plus the fact that slower economic growth in other parts of the world means less overall demand for oil, which will take further pressure off the price.
And there are some who are suggesting China can't continue to just oversee everything the way they do, and that some deregulation there might also maybe take a little bit of air out of the balloon. That make any sense?
It does, because they do have large influence over a lot of the prices that their people in their economy pay, and it costs money to do that. And one of these days, you either run out of money or you let prices go where they're supposed to go. The other thing is that there's some evidence that the Chinese economy may, in fact, be on the verge of starting to slow down some. It still will be very fast compared to us. And if that happens, that'll take further pressure off the prices.
All right. Tracy, thank you so much for joining us. Good information. Tracy Clark, ASU Economist. Thank you.